Welcome on board this beast. She's a Mayori 78, built in 2014. She's capable of doing top speeds in excess of 40 knots, and it's basically the essence of French Riviera speed yachting. The two MAN V12 engines play their muscles at 1,900 horsepower each. Coupled to two hydraulically steered jolly surface drives, you get the big rooster tail water fountain thrown out behind the boat. She may look and drive like a beast, a perfect day boat loaded with toys, but you will be surprised about the three spacious cabins and the main deck saloon. This saloon was added in the 2016 refit. Before, the yacht was completely open as shown in these pictures. During this refit, they added the center console with all technical gadgets, also containing a hob for the open galley on the port side. And there's so many gadgets. If you press this button, there's a complete tray of plugs where you can plug in the network cable, USB, HDMI, electronics, you can recharge the phones, and also you can, if you have a phone with a coil inside, you can put it here, it gets recharged. There's another one, and then the TV is integrated down here. Table, the rise and fall hydraulically, so you can also lower them for some drinks like lounge tables or have dinner. And here on the port side you have a completely equipped galley. If you open this up, you have a sink, a hob extractor, cooktop, microwave, fridges, then more fridge on this side, a oven, and also here you have a top that you can open for some worktop. And then basically here you have a wine cooler that opens to this side, if you know, then it's easy, and a washing machine. For me, this helm station is beautifully laid out and very cleaned up, so everything is within reach and you have a good overview. You see well to the front, and then over here we have the jolly drive system from the surface drives where you control the trim of the shafts with those two levers, and also you have the indication for the flaps that you control over here. These are the engine displays, beautiful switches that you can just attach like this, Furuno autopilot, navigation, maps, and then very important to mention is the Seakeeper gyro stabilization system. And this one has not only one but two, so she's laying at anchor really stable and of course also on the way. Now let's check the outside of the yacht, which is actually the most important part. I'll just take the camera and show you everything. So we go to the front, and there you have a super spacious lounge with a table that is on a hydraulic foot that you can also lower down and then put some two actually plates on it, and then you have an additional supersized sunbathing. Forward there is the crew cabin with three beds actually down here, so let me open this for you quickly. That's the crew cabin. Of course it's also used for storage while driving fast. And then the anchor is actually on a hydraulic mechanism that goes completely inside the boat, so you don't have anything that destroys this beautiful line. And then of course there is some storage. Here are the life rafts in these sockets, and then of course you notice again a lot of those carbon fiber details. And look at this beautiful line. This shows how spacious the bow actually is. In the back you can rest in the shade under the sun sail, mounted on full carbon masts. Talking about carbon fiber, there are many clever details on this yacht made from carbon fiber to underline the high-speed character. For example, those fender holders practically store all fenders while cruising and integrate it nicely into the line of the yacht. Anyway, this yacht is full of gadgets, from the hydraulic anchor, the pop-out lights, the hidden winches to the transformer platform. If you love gadgets, this is the right yacht for you. Now before we jump into the water, let's have a quick look at the cabins. On the starboard side there's the staircase going into the master cabin. Walking down the stairs you arrive immediately at the master cabin, which in my opinion is surprisingly generous with the double bed, the three signature square window on each side allowing lots of natural light. And also you have this little sofa and then quite a lot of storage. And now continuing into the front, we have the bathroom located forward. which also again has a lot of storage, is generously arranged, and the shower actually offers a little wooden bench to sit down, and then the toilet is with a nice mirror door, and also it's just large enough. Coming out from the master cabin, there's this center corridor that also leads to the day head. And let me take the camera and show you quickly the guest cabin. So over here on the starboard side, you have this nice bigger bed. It's not actually a full double bed, but I think if you quite like each other, it's gonna be snuggly and romantic. So then you could actually fit two people in here. And on the other side, on the port side, you have again the same sized bed, and then a smaller one which could be also for kids. And there's quite a lot of storage if you open those drawers also down here. So I think it's actually nicely done. It feels quite spacious, and this sliding door actually partitions off this central corridor. So that basically when you want the guests just to go into the day head, they can do so. And then this one is the day head. And here's the sliding door with that partition. And the carpet is very comfortable. Everything is very cozy, very minimalistic and light. So it's really nice atmosphere, and you're surprised how spacious it actually is down here. Now it's time to get changed into bathing shorts. Or the bathing suit. I don't know how English guy is actually saying this, but anyway, I'm gonna test the toys now and have some fun. Amazing. These sea lobs days, they're so much fun. Mayori 78. I had so much fun today trying out all these toys, and I must confess, I'm a little bit hooked on this concept, because going so fast from one anchorage to another, relax, sunbathe, and when you're too hot, just jump into the water and do some water sports. It's a pretty amazing concept. If you feel like going to Saint-Tropez, you can just take off with 35 knots cruising and arrive there in under 1 hour. Corsica 3 hours, and Monaco also less than 1 hour, all measured from Cannes. With so much fun to offer and the generous space, you will likely have your friends who want to come on board all the time. And that's what this yacht is made for, to have fun on the water. And if you're interested to buy such a day boat that is fully stabilized with a transformer platform packed with toys, she is for sale now in Cannes. So don't hesitate to send me a WhatsApp, give me a call, and please consider subscribing. Thank you for watching the video.
We speak yachting. Let's talk.